Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna talk a little bit about the lore behind Juilet Green, about her life, and yeah, let's just get into it. I feel like her character and the very opening of the game was just a character that was there, you know, like many of the other supporting cast. You had Xavier and Melina and Matthias, and it wasn't until recent that they became relevant to the plot and more thought out, which I think is so fun and interesting to think that there might be characters now that aren't really talked about, but they could become like the main character. They could have this deep story. But is that she was born and mostly raised in France with her twin brother Romeo. I feel like she and him were probably among the small few that had the least time with their siblings, which is why they are so close. Like, I feel like they fostered that bond so easily. And I do think that she spent time in Sweden, but I feel as if she also spent a lot of time with Matthias and Alex, you know, when they were getting older in their teen years, because Italy borders France, so I can see a lot of that. There was actually a piece written about her younger years, and from what I could gather from that very short piece, is that her and Romeo actually went to high school together, and she was popular, but not like normal popular. She was like, you know, very outspoken about human rights, and she was very environmental and things like that, so she wasn't your usual popular girl, but I do think that she was popular because she was in fact a green. Then in the game, she sort of, I feel like after that, I'm going through her timeline, she probably like fades out, and then she resurfaces sort of during the time when Nikki was still reigning in Russia. She became a character that was noted to resemble Melina Ashley, like physically wise, and that's all you really knew of her. And you knew that she was seeing one of the Lars, like that was the thing, like she was seeing one of the Lars. And the more that I think about it, Juilet and Xavier, they truly are day ones. Like, they have been going out together for a very long time, and they still feel so fresh, new, and young, and like it's crazy. So what we know about her career is like a big part of her character. She actually is like an art dealer. Xavier says she's workaholic, but the fine art industry is where she works in, and it's highbrow, you know, the areas that she deals art, and it's been her thing for a long time, which I think is so interesting. Like, how does she go about these spaces with her, you know, big, you know, human activist, you know, like she's big on that. And yeah, I feel like with Romeo, they both ran in these circles that were the same. He was a documentary photographer, basically. He documented cultures and life, and I feel like they did a lot of stuff like that hand in hand. Speaking of Romeo, a huge part of her character has a lot to do with the relationship that she had with her twin. Sometime in the 20 BD, before Delusion, Romeo was actually set out to capture images of life, like in the Philippines, you know, in the islands area, and that's where like a horrific event took place. There was this massive tsunami and earthquake, and he was among the missing people. And then I think a few years passed by, and then he was just presumed dead. But after that time, like, kept going, they find out that he was in fact alive, but he suffered from amnesia. And this little bit of her life, not really little, his return really affected her relationship with Xavier. It affected her relationship with her siblings. It affected her relationship with them. And it really affected how she viewed her father, because it was said that Mr. Green knew that he was where he was. He just didn't tell his siblings. So she's very different from the other greens, I would say. Like, she's a green, but almost in sheep's clothing. I always like to think about the little back and forth she shared with Becca Pacino, because he's like said, like, I know this about you. Like, he said, and I quote, I think roughly quote, he's like, you are the smartest one. He knows who she is. And I think that's very interesting for them to kind of have that hit back. But yes, not to completely go off topic or, you know, whatever, but when Romeo came back, this triggered something inside of her, which goes on to her sickness. And the main elephant in the room is what happened with her and Miss Christofferson. And I will talk about that in part 2. Thanks so much for watching.